the season has been going quite nicely. How much of a shock to the system has the weekend been?
Well, you know, we looked at Europe as in the three phases, really, in the three stages that it happens. And when I looked at it, I felt that we needed a minimum of 5 points from that first group of two games. So in that respect, you know, we've got what we targeted. However, I felt after the first game, we were in a very strong position to do something a little bit special. And unfortunately, we weren't able to deliver on that. So, you know, Europe has been one almighty roller coaster, really. Some great highs and some huge lows as well. But at the end of it, we've come up the other side, still in the fight for a European quarter-final place. We're encouraged by that. We've got a good series of games for us next against Treviso, home and away. That was always going to be a key part of this tournament for us, and we're going to have to win both those games. And then we'd really look forward to welcoming Leicester back down here.
I was wondering almost that, you know, you've taken Perpignan apart, obviously a top European side, you matched the Ospreys, another top European side, and then suddenly,
I think, you know, what you've got to remember is when you look at the game in detail, there were three moments, particularly at the start of the second half, that we got wrong, our errors. And when you play in the top end of European rugby with its intensity and the quality of opposition, any mistakes and errors like that will be punished, and we were punished. In fairness, they were pretty ruthless on the day, probably the best that they've played for a long time, and probably the worst we've played all season. So, you know, those are all factors. We're hugely disappointed with that performance, and more importantly, the result. But as I say, you know, we know that we're still in the fight. We're going to get up and brush ourselves down. And when Europe comes round next, we'll be ready for Leicester in particular. But now we have other things to focus on.
What sort of shape you're in for the derby?
We're in fine shape. You know, I think that a lot of senior international rugby players realise that you have to manage success and failure in the same way. And you can't be too static when things go well, and you can't be too negative when things don't go so well. And you've just got to manage that emotion, and you know, that's what professional sports people do. The best one, certainly. So, you know, that's where we are. We're going into a big local derby game. We'll no doubt will not be the favourites for this match, because the Blues are going very well as well. They've probably had a similar start to the season to us in many ways. I'm pleased with the strength of the squad, although we've picked up a couple of injuries. But I've said from day one that, particularly in the domestic league, that you're going to rely on the strength of your squad. You cannot keep on going back to the same players. It doesn't work that way. It can't work that way. We will make some alterations this week, and we'll make some alterations the following week. But in the knowledge that we've now got a real competitive squad, and we've got people competing for the shirt. Yeah, we're hoping that John's going to be available. He's trained well. And we're just hoping for no reaction from his ankle, really.
Which is a boost, considering the form he was in before.
Yeah, it's a boost. You know, he gives us a lot of options there. I've been very pleased with Gareth Moore's form as well, and Regan King's. But it gives us more options there, a different style of player, and maybe a different combination of players there as well.
In terms of the Welsh squad members, are they all available for this weekend?
They will be all available this weekend, but I don't think they're available next weekend. So again, you know, I don't know. You know, that I think the senior players probably won't be, but you know, maybe some of the boys coming back from injury might be, and that's why I don't quite know. You know, that's a call that Wales will have to make. It's in their control, really, whether they allow them to play or not. So we're assuming that they're not going to, but we may well have a couple of players that they want to play. I think that's important when you look at the season, you look at the key games that happen in the periods where there's international rugby, both the autumn and the Six Nations. This week is very important to us. Glasgow is extremely important to us. We know we want to have certain players available for the Glasgow game, so it's an opportunity maybe to also give players a chance to run out against quality opposition, the Blues, which maybe, you know, they haven't had opportunities or that many opportunities today to do. So you've got to manage your resources particularly cleverly, I think, in these periods.
People like Stephen and Matthew probably play quite a bit of rugby at the beginning the season, Stephen Jones, Matthew Rees, are there the decisions you've got to make on those sort of players this week?
Yeah, and you know, and if you look at the players behind that, Ken and Priestland, you know, they're quality players as well who have really shown great form when they've played. So, you know, it gives us some great options to have there. And, you know, there's not saying that Matthew and Steve can't be involved in some way.
George North, obviously, he's still coming up when you've been named in the World Squad this year.
It's obviously very early for him, but I think he's shown a lot of potential. He's shown his worth. Great stature, great pace, intelligent rugby player. You know, if I look at him, I'm not trying to hype him up in any way at all, but he just looks a natural international rugby player to me. It's obviously early for him, and we don't want to put any pressure on him. I'm sure other people will do that. But, yeah, you know, he does look very much an international rugby player. It's probably 2 to 3 weeks away. So, you know, although George will be involved in the Welsh squad, I would anticipate, in all reality, that he'll have to play some rugby for us before, if at all, he gets considered for any of the autumn series games.
Are you able to manage that? How you manage that?
No, I don't think so. I think it's very difficult, isn't it? Yeah, I think it's very difficult. And, you know, if we're honest, you know, we want to manage it to a certain extent, but, you know, we want people to be excited by the players that we have here as well, which, you know, maybe we haven't been able to do for a couple of years. And that's important. It's important for us. It's important for our team. It's important for our supporters. And it's important for our brand.
Josh Trimble, unlucky,
Yeah, you know, I think he has been unlucky. They've obviously made calls, they've had some tough calls to make. But Josh, you know, can feel aggrieved, I think. What he's just got to do is keep playing well. And, you know, he'll probably have a great opportunity on Friday night to do that. And local derby against some of his competitors, I'm sure he'll be up for that one.
How important has it been for George North's development that he's been here? You've got the obvious contrast with Tom Friday, who's just simply not playing. You've been able to give him games, you've been able to develop him in a way.
In George, his position, you know, I've said to him right from day one, really, that there will be opportunities here for him. And we can coach these players for the next 30 years, but unless they play at the level that they're training at and the level that they need to play at, they will never develop into the players they can be. And George has certainly benefited from having exposure at the level that we play at. And, you know, he's almost to the man of born, really. He's fitting in very well. And more than that, he hasn't just been a passenger, he's been impacting games for us. But I think the fact that he's played at the level, you know, he's played against some very talented players already, he knows the standard that he has to aspire to. And it's been great for him. The pace of the game, everything about what he does when he plays for us, gives him that extra confidence and belief that he can play at that level, and also gives him his development. A bit of a mixed bag start, a bit like us, but they have a real quality squad, a lot of strength in depth, and they've proved, you know, over the last couple of years in particular, they've got some big games in them as well. So in many ways they're pretty similar when we look at it to Leicester. They bring a good intensity to their game. They've got some key players that can really impact the game as well. So very good side. It's a side that we've struggled against last season, and the season before we did quite well against. So it'll be interesting to see where both teams are on Friday.
Rodri,
and by Rodri Jones on Sunday night, I don't really know much about him. Is he someone you're looking at to lose more perhaps this season as well, with the resources in Jay's mind as well? Yeah, we have to with the resources, you know, but more than that, I think Rodri is an excellent player. He's got great stature. He is only 18, which is exceptionally young for a front row forward, and for him to be exposed in that environment, it doesn't get much tougher than that, really. So it's all downhill from here on in for him. So he's experienced, you know, the top end of the game in the position he plays. And, you know, he acquitted himself very well. You know, for an 18-year-old boy, fantastic. He's shown up really well in training. So we're very excited about him. And again, it's just the philosophy down here to support and back and develop what we've got. Wherever we can do, and, you know, particularly where we feel there's real talent there, we will do that.